the Spanish Inquisition. Our chief weapon is surprise. Surprise and fear. Fear and surprise are two weapons. Our fear and surprise and ruthless efficiency are three weapons. Our fear and surprise and ruthless efficiency and an almost fanatical devotion to the Pope are four. No. Amongst our weapons. Amongst our weaponry are such elements as fear. I'll come in again.
The Spanish Inquisition was established by Ferdinand II of Aragon and Isabella I of Castile in 1478. Essentially, they wanted their own state-run Inquisition, rather than a papal one, to enhance their Catholic street cred. Fun fact, it was not abolished until 1834. That's 356 years worth of Inquisition. In the same year, Pope Sixtus IV published the papal bull Exigit Sinceris Devotionis Affectus, which translated from gibberish just means that he put his official stamp of approval on it. Initially, it was intended to combat heresy for the emperor, their most Catholic majesties. Unfortunately, for anyone of considerable wealth, it was extremely profitable for the monarchy to condemn them and confiscate their resources. Here we have an authentic photo of an actual Inquisition torture chamber. But let's back up a second. Before you'd be tortured, there needed to be two accusers. Then you would receive a summons in the mail to a trial. At your trial, you'd be asked if you were a heretic. If you said no, you'd be tortured until you said yes. If you said yes, you'd be tortured until you gave up some of your supposed fellow heretics. You see, the torture wasn't the punishment, only to coerce the victim into admitting that they're a heretic. The torture devices used by the Spanish Inquisition were designed to break bone, dislocate joints, or just cause general agony without too much blood. This was because the inquisitors were forbidden from drawing blood when trying to extract a confession. A little would be forgiven, flaying someone would not. We'll begin with waterboarding. So effective, we still use it today. The person's mouth is covered with cloth, and then they have water poured over their face to simulate drowning. One of the few Inquisition torture methods you can try at home. The water cure. A funnel would be placed in the victim's mouth and water forced into their stomach until it became visibly distended. Then they would beat the torturee or hang them by their feet until they vomited all the water out, only to start round two. With the Spanish boot, one or both legs would be secured in a vice-like boot, depending on the style. One type would essentially be a big vice for your leg. The other, like the one pictured, would be designed to have wooden wedges hammered into the sides of it. Both variations would shatter bone. The heretic's fork wasn't designed to torture in and of itself, but to assist in sleep deprivation, similar in effect to modern-day stress positions. The iron chair. Yes, it is probably as uncomfortable as it looks. It had two main styles, one where the victim was weighed down, and another where the bottom of the chair was heated. The rack. It costs one colorless mana. Wrong rack. This rack was a stretching device with a number of variations, designed to make heretics taller, that they may feel closer to heaven and convert from their heathen ways. Or just to break bones, minor details. The strappado. Your hands would be bound behind your back, and you would be lifted by them and sometimes dropped, repeatedly. As you can imagine, this would dislocate the shoulders of most people. The Spanish donkey. It's sort of a torture cousin to the Judas cradle. The victim would be weighed down and made to straddle it for extended periods of time. The one you sickos have been waiting for, the Judas cradle. The victim would be suspended over this pyramid, and their body weight, or sometimes extra weights, would force them down on it. The orifice impaled depended on gender, and the victim would sometimes be left on it overnight, or in extreme cases, until the pyramid pierced something vital. Either way, it seems definitely unpleasant, as evidenced by the testimony of the man pictured here. 0 out of 10 would not try again. The pear, otherwise known as the Pope's pear, the pear of anguish, and you're gonna put that where? designed for any body orifice. When the handle is turned at the end, it expands, stretching wherever it was put. And before you ask, no, I cannot explain or fathom why there's an ornate version of such a device. The tablilla. See those five holes? They're made for five toes. Every time you answer a question in an unsatisfactory way, the Inquisitor, or his bulky but mute henchman, would bash one of your toes with a hammer. It's used on the toes and not the fingers, because the fingers would simply break, but the toe would be completely pulverized. Thumb screws. Pretty self-explanatory. Your thumbs are put into a vise and squeezed. I've got photos of two variations here, a spiked one and a smooth one. This concludes my brief overview of the history of torture in the Spanish Inquisition. I hope you learned something new today, otherwise this was a complete waste of your time.